What if I ask you a simple question? Are you looking for a job or you're looking beyond your job and maybe having your eye at your career? What if I tell you that to advance in your career, you should be looking at 10 things early so that you are consolidating consciously and working towards advancement of career once you have shortlisted the vision of career. So here are 10 things to learn from your workplace to advance on your career. First and foremost is the industry that you are in. If you are aware that you are in a particular industry, then what services and products are being offered? How does the business operate? You can build up your industry knowledge from these observations. If you plan to advance your career in this industry, you can open up yourself to different roles within this industry. For example, a sales representative in a retail store can move into operations, design, or merchandising. If you plan to work as a contractor, building up industry knowledge is essential to your success. If you can accumulate knowledge in multiple industries, it will open up your work opportunities to a much wider range of clients. Are there any external factors that may affect the business? That is, technological evolution, demographics change, politics, economy, etc., etc. Check out if your company is on the rising trend or part of an industry-wide decline. This gives you insight whether to stay and invest more in it or start looking somewhere else. Having a big picture mindset is one of your key differentiators. It reflects your potential for a bigger role in the company and is crucial for managerial positions. Insight about the future of the industry is part of having a vision. Another differentiator to impress your future employer during an interview, it shows your diligence in researching about the job. Not only the company, but the industry and its future. And that you are proactive in anticipating the upcoming changes and are prepared to capitalize from it. If you're seeking for a promotion to managerial position, this is the quality that will give you the advantage over your peers. Second is the business model. Where does revenue come from? What are the top cost areas? How is business success measured? This financial knowledge deepens your understanding of the financial aspects of the company operations. If you are advancing to a senior position, you can analyze which operation areas are candidates for outsourcing and technological automation to reduce cost or to invest in innovation to improve revenue. This strategic mindset is a prerequisite for managerial positions. If you are at a junior position, you wouldn't want to land in the highest cost departments and become victim of job cuts and reorganization. The fact that you can outline these money areas of the company you have worked in despite your junior role demonstrate your business acumen to your future employer. If you plan to start your own business, these are the areas you want to evaluate yourself to see if you are naturally good at them. Otherwise, you will need to recruit a very good partner to help you out. Number third, the customers. Who are the customers and how are they segmented? What constitutes customer satisfaction? How are customers attracted and retained? Customers are always the core part of a business, so knowing how your company addresses customer needs and how your work relates to it will help you build a convincing story in your next interview. Describing your job role is mechanical, but explaining how your job adds value to customers demonstrates value to the business. If you are interested in starting your own business at a later time, this is the best opportunity for you to learn. Understanding customer strategy is a key competency required by managerial marketing and customer service roles. Number 4, location of business. Does the company operate, work with partners, or sell products in multiple locations? That is, how global is the business? In the current connected economy and technological evolution, having global experience is a huge advantage. If you do work with colleagues in other locations, you have a great opportunity to develop very useful communication skills through exposure to different work cultures. Here are some examples. A bi-weekly meeting means meeting once every 2 weeks to most people, but others may interpret it as meeting twice a week. Now, the British prefers to call it fortnightly meeting. People in Hong Kong prefer to work late rather than meet early in the morning. This is the opposite to the general North American culture. For those whose mother tongue is not English, saying yes in an audio conference meeting may simply be acknowledging your point. It doesn't necessarily mean they agree. If someone from UK says, "I hear you," you may interpret as, "I understand and accept your viewpoint," but that actually means, "I disagree and I don't want to discuss it further." If anybody says, "I almost agree," it means, "I don't agree at all." Rather, they are not far from agreement. The ability to communicate and build relationships with people from different cultures is a great asset if you apply for jobs in large multinational organizations or companies that interact with colleagues from different cultures, international customers, or business partners. As well, a global company means you have the opportunity to travel and perhaps be transferred to work in other cities or countries. The exposure will help expand your options in your future career. Number 5, organization structure. What does the management ladder look like? How many layers from the most junior employee to the CEO? Hierarchical, more rules and bureaucracy, but less confusion. Creativity will likely be limited. Flat, more freedom, more potential to experiment new ideas, likely more peer politics and require much stronger interpersonal skills. Matrix, you report to more than one boss. Example, a product manager may functionally report to a business head and an IT head. Your performance is measured by whether your designed product meets business needs and is viable from IT perspective. Another example is when there are teams in remote locations, where the remote teams report to an onshore manager with a local administrative manager handling morale and HR matters. This structure is usually limited to larger companies and for more senior employees and managers. It can be confusing as to which boss to please, but an excellent training ground for navigating through complex organizations. What types of positions are available? Example, IT, product management, finance, accounting, purchasing, logistics, operations, customer service, etc. How do the reporting lines look like? Understanding the structure of your organization gives you direct information for your horizontal and vertical move options. Many companies are being forced to review their organization structure in recent years because of technological and market changes, increased pressure on cost efficiency, and heightened competition from new players. Learning about the structure of your organization and how different structures work will give you the advantage in choosing how to navigate organization changes. For example, in a traditional hierarchical organization, having a large team of subordinates represents an advantage for promotion to senior level of management. In a matrix organization where most junior employees belong to a resource pool, being the manager of the resource pool is not a career enhancing position because the role is administrative of nature, like the owner of the contracting company that augments resource to other companies, instead taking on strategic and mission critical projects, which would be a better move. Organizational awareness is an indication of your maturity level in job interviews. As well, it will also affirm your big picture mindset. Organization structure has strong influence on how you work with your boss and colleagues. Organization's culture, number 6. Observing soft traits of your company is an important step to help yourself examine what type of work environment you like or hate. Traits of the organization, example, innovative, aggressive, outcome-oriented, stable, people-oriented, or detailed-oriented. Communication, how information and strategy is communicated through your boss or a town hall meeting with top executives speaking to large employee groups directly. How decisions are made, according to seniority, by consensus, or by reasoning. Change resistance. Is the organization an advocate to change or they change resistant? There's no good or bad culture. Mapping your preferences along with real experience working as a part of it will give you some clarity of your personality or preferences versus career fit. For example, if you are a structured person and you like to create and follow rules to execute tasks efficiently, an innovative culture may not fit you. If you are creative and like to move fast, you wouldn't be comfortable working in a stable and detail-oriented culture that resists change. When you start building up awareness in this area, you can look for employers with culture that matches your preference. More importantly, this becomes a convincing story you can tell your employer during an interview why it's a good match.